Hi everyone, I'm Daniel Roth from the Blazor team. In this video, we're gonna get set up to build and run our first Blazor web app. To get started with Blazor, you're gonna wanna first go to blazor.net, right there. That's the your magic URL that will take you to the Blazor homepage. And on this site, you will find all sorts of useful information about Blazor, like the links to the Blazor docs and details about Blazor's many features. Go ahead and click on the Get Started button, and then click on Let's Get Started. All right, here you'll find the Blazor tutorial, which has instructions for multiple platforms for Windows, Mac, and also Linux. On Windows, you can get started with Blazor using Visual Studio, a fully featured integrated development environment, or IDE. Go ahead and if you're on Windows, go ahead and download Visual Studio. This will download the free community edition of Visual Studio. And then once that's downloaded, go ahead and run the installer. Okay, so in the Visual Studio installer, you can then select which workloads you want to install. For Blazor, all you really need is the web development workload, which is the first one up in the upper left-hand corner. So go ahead and select that and then click Install. I've already installed it, so I'm gonna close out of this and then go ahead and launch Visual Studio. All right, once you're in Visual Studio, we're gonna create a new project. And then you're gonna wanna select the Blazor web app template, this one up here at the top. If you don't see it, you can filter for just the web templates by using this right drop-down box and just select web or just search for Blazor. Okay, this is where you can pick where do you want that Blazor web app to go. I'm just gonna use the default here, click Next. There are some options we can tweak then with the project. Just leave all the defaults and go ahead and click Create. There you go, you just created your first Blazor web app project. Let's go ahead and run it. To run it, go ahead up to the top and click the green play button, and that will build and run your Blazor web app, run it in the debugger. Awesome, okay, there it is over here running. There's our Blazor web app running in the browser. You can see we have a simple web application with a few different pages. On the home page, we've got some static content. We have a counter page with a button that we can click and the count goes up. And then this weather page that displays a table of randomly generated weather forecast data. Now we can snap this side by side, let's do it side by side with Visual Studio. And Visual Studio will watch our files as we make code changes. For example, let's find that home page and home.razor right there. And we can edit this hello world text, which is right here in this H1 heading. Let's change this to great job. We'll go ahead and save that and then click the hot reload button, that little flame icon in the toolbar. And there the change has been applied to our Blazor web application. Awesome, so that was easy. Okay, so that's how you can get started with Visual Studio on Windows. All right, but what if you're not on Windows? You can also get started with Blazor from the command line using just the .NET SDK. And we have instructions for how to do that on Mac, on Linux, and on Windows there are instructions as well. You can find them right here at this link right there. If you prefer to get started from the command line using whatever editor you'd like, go ahead and click on that link and then click on Let's Get Started. Okay, so you're going to want to download and install the .NET SDK. On Windows, you can just download the .NET SDK installer. So I'll go ahead and do that. Great, once that's downloaded, go ahead and click on it to run the installer. Awesome, and then click Install. Done. Okay, once the .NET SDK is installed, I recommend, it looks like we still have our running app window open there, we'll close that. Once the .NET SDK is installed, I recommend going to the terminal and just checking that the install installed cleanly, and you can do that just by running .NET --version, and this should display the version of the .NET SDK that you have installed. It should be 8.0 or later. If you see that, then you are good to go. All right, and then now we can create our Blazor web app from the command line. To do that, you run the command .NET new, which creates new projects, and then the project we want to create is a Blazor project. You can also then select where do you want the app to go. Like I think I'll make this one my, I think I was on 4 before, so let's make this my 5th one, Blazor app 5. Go ahead and run that command, and then the .NET SDK will generate our Blazor web app for us. There it is. Well, I guess we have to go into the folder that it just created, and we'll list it right there. Awesome. Okay, now how do we run this? So to run our Blazor web app from the command line, we run .NET run. okay? That will build and then run the application. Once we see the log output, we can just click on the link, and then there's our Blazor web app that we just ran from the command line. Easy peasy. Now that's really convenient. .NET Run will just build and run the app once. What's even more convenient is instead of doing that, and by the way, we can stop the app by just hitting Control C. There's another command which is .NET Watch. And what .NET Watch will do is it will build and run the app, but then also watch the files for file changes and then apply those file changes to the running app as you're making them using your favorite text editor. It will apply them using hot reload or even restart the app if it needs to be restarted. So .NET Watch, super convenient to get your developer workflow going smoothly. All right, so then use whatever editor you'd like. If you're a Visual Studio Code user, we can do Blazor development in Visual Studio Code. Let me go ahead and stop this app. There we go. We can close this. So I have Visual Studio Code installed here. With Visual Studio Code, it looks like I had a previously installed created Blazor app. We'll go ahead and close that. So I have Visual Studio Code installed here. With Visual Studio Code, you're going to want to install the C# Dev Kit extension, which I've got right there. And this will give you a really great cross-platform developer experience for C#-based apps. Okay. Once you've got that installed, then you can click on the File Explorer, and there should be this Create.NET Project button. Go ahead and click that. And it will offer you a list of available .NET projects. You're going to want to select the Blazor web app project. And then we pick where do we want to put it. I'll put it alongside all the other ones that I've just created in my repos folder. Looks like we're up to 5, so let's do Blazor app 6. We'll select that location. Now, Visual Studio Code is then going to ask me to pick a name for my project. Usually, I just have that be the same name as the location where it's sitting. And there we go. Now we have our Blazor web app created in Visual Studio Code. And what's nice about having that C# Dev Kit extension installed is that in addition to just like the file system view of the project, I also get this Solution Explorer view, which is like .NET's view of the project, all the files that are actually included with the build. And you can also see all of your dependencies. It gives you a lot of nice information about your project. Now to run this, we can just open one of the like the C# files and then click the Run and Debug button. Click Run and Debug again to set up the which debugger you want to use. You should pick C#. And then you can select which launch profile you'd like to use. Just select a default. And then this should run our Blazor web app from Visual Studio Code in the debugger. And there it is again. Okay. Alternatively, you can run the app using .NET Watch from the Visual Studio Code terminal. And that's really convenient because then you can edit the code and see the changes really quickly. So I'm going to go ahead and stop this. And then let's head over to the terminal. We'll open a new terminal. There we go. And then I'll change into my Blazor app 6 directory. You want to make sure you're in the directory that you want to run. And we'll run .NET Watch from here. And I just often just will have this running in the terminal in Visual Studio Code while I'm making code changes. Okay, so if we pop this over to the side, and make sure I don't have any accidental changes in program CS. There we go. And then if we go to our code in the Solution Explorer, let's bring up again that home component where that heading is being defined right there. Give ourselves a little bit more room. And instead of Hello World, let's put, you did great. Go ahead and save that. And then just by saving it, .NET Watch will detect the change and apply it to our running app. Awesome. All right. So in just a few minutes, we were able to set up our Blazor development environment and create and run our first Blazor web app. In the next video, we'll look at the components that make up this project and start to understand how they work.